Normally when we're talking to Tom Roy, we're standing in a sorghum field or a soybean field, but Tom, some folks might have woken up pretty recently with their yards, you know, pretty chewed down by armyworms.
Some of them, even when they called me, they said, 3 days ago I had a green lawn, today I got a dead lawn. I mean, it was that quick. So yes, we've been getting a lot of calls on that, and it's due to fall armyworm. The thing with fall armyworms that's interesting is that there's two strains. We have one that we call the corn strain. That's the one that comes out of South Texas that overwinters there and then kind of comes up the Central Plains most years. There's another strain called the rice strain that likes grasses more, even more than corn and sorghum. And it comes, it overwinters in Florida, but we've had some different kind of weather this year. And apparently it brought them into Oklahoma and it surprised everybody.
When we're talking about damage, is that something that you know, people are gonna have to consider, you know, going back into the spring if their yard is really torn down?
Well, there's I think two situations. It's been my experience that it's really hard to kill Bermuda grass. It'll take it, they'll come out and maybe make the yard look bad now, but Bermuda grass is very resilient, it'll come back. If you seeded something like, if you seeded fescue, grass or something like that, might be a little different story, and you may have to redo it, because if they get down and chew on the newly seeded fescue, it probably won't come back and you'll have to reseed.
So management, I mean, you have a little setup right here. So what are we looking at? What can people do to try to control this?
This is for people that want to know whether they should treat or not. And hopefully they're doing this before they have a dead lawn. It's just basically get a little soap, putting a couple teaspoons of soap or tablespoons of soap in a gallon of water. And what happens is that the armyworms don't like this when it's sprayed on there, or when you put it on the ground and they're hiding under the thatch. They don't like the soap and it irritates them, and they come to the surface once they get exposed to it. So what we do is just typically suggest that we go into an area like this and just back and forth over, you know, maybe like a square yard or so. And if it gets down and touches them, they'll come right up out of the ground. I've seen it happen a lot of times, and it's a way for a homeowner to decide whether they need to treat or not. The armyworm has a life cycle of about 30 days. So whatever is out here now is gonna be pupating. They'll be in the soil for a while. They'll come out as adult moths and they'll mate and start laying eggs. So every 30 days, we could have another cycle, but producers need to be aware of them because they can come out every 30 days until we get a killing frost. They'll be here.
Finally, before we let you go, you know, shifting off to, you know, our crops, sorghum, maybe even soybean, and then of course, as you know, wheat starts to come up when after planting. So what are you seeing right now in regards to our crops?
Well, I know sorghum growers, especially if you're growing double crop sorghum, soybean, you got to be careful of it, because if these caterpillars don't have anything else to heat, they'll move on to that. And then of course, wheat growers in the fall when we start seeding, they need to be on top of it too, because you want to get that crop going, especially if you're going to graze cattle in the fall. Normally, I don't recommend treating fall armyworm and world stage sorghum before the head comes out, because they're also a headworm. But this year, I would probably change my recommendations and say, yeah, you need to be treating, because there's enough of the fall armyworms out there in large enough numbers that maybe need to protect your sorghum crop.
All right, thanks, Tom. Tom Royer, extension entomologist here at Oklahoma State University. And Tom has a lot of fact sheets on armyworms, and for a link to that, go to our website, sunup.okstate.edu.